Hello, well, here I am again, the joiner that likes to diversify. This time we're going to cover trailers. Now, I scoured the web for trailers because I needed one, and being in the north end of the UK, very difficult to come across one, but I found a company down south, way down south, that actually sell flat pack trailers. Very good quality ones. Deliver them flat pack on a pallet and you assemble it. Not major heart surgery to do it. But after that, I searched then YouTube for some insight as to assembling this to see if anybody had done one. You know, I mean, these sort of things people like to show. Not one. There's none. There's one small minor one from the manufacturers. Doesn't show up much more pictures than anything else. And it's too easy to do, so why not just do one to help those that might have a little bit of difficulty in assembling it. The company, Paxton Trailers, just in case you should need. Right, so let's have a look at what we've got. Now, as I say, it all comes flat pack, laying it out in an order so that it's easy to assemble, like I have here. We've got first the base. It's all galvanized steel, so no plywood stuff to rot and waste away. And very good solid box sections. Leaf springs, so you're going to get the maximum payload that you can get on there. There's the A-frame, and look at the solidness of that A-frame. Really well made. Good security chain. The hitch up bolt, and I've got a hitch lock as well, which you get with them as an added extra. Then you've got the axle, which attaches to the leaf springs, the wheels for each side, of course, and then moving on, we have boxer accessories. They even send you a few tools, as you can see there, just in case you buy one of these and you don't have a toolbox. It could happen, I suppose. The electrics, full kit. Nice lights, well secured. They sit on the outside of the body, so they've got this armour plating around them. Mud guards and a couple of courtesy Paxton mud flaps. Then you've got the jockey wheel, and I bought myself, which is added extras, a couple of corner steadies. They're only, well, they're less than 20 quid each then, when you buy them together. So it's a good deal and well worth having. It means you can jump in and out of the trailer without any bother. Then you've got the main body. Here we are, they're the two long sections for the two sides and the back pieces. Really good quality locking devices, as you can see there. Very good, solid. Gonna be reasonably easy, I think, to put together. And then I got this cage which sits on top. It gives me a total depth inside the box of near enough a metre, 960 or 980 or something, but it's very deep. Now these trailers come in a variety of sizes, 6x4, 6x5, 7x4, 7x5 and 8x5, I think, around that. Anyway, the one I picked was the 7x5, that's this one. That is the inside payload size, 7x5. Okay, now I'm going to be quiet now and start going through the assembly. Just watching, I can't see there being anything difficult, but if there is, you'll see how I fathom my way around it, and then you can do it just a little bit easier. Thank you. Now, a point to note on this, when you're first laying it out, you need to determine which is the front and which is the back, otherwise you're going to get the leaf springs the wrong way around. And the way to do that, and there is only one way I can see so far, and that is that the bolt holes for the A-frame are drilled in the back. They're just dummies where they could go, but they've actually drilled it all the way through. So look on the both ends for this end that has got the holes drilled all the way through. That is the end of the A-frame, hence that is the front. Now, when you're putting the leaf springs on, the closed part of the leaf spring, you know what I mean if you're looking at one, that is the front part of it. So you get them on first. Now, the way they're packed, it seems to be making life very simple for us, because that I've just opened one pack of bolts and everything I needed to put the suspension on was in that one pack, and I've used it up complete. So we didn't need to go guessing which bolt was for which. Now, to attach the A-frame, then it's ready to turn over. I've got the four lighter nut bolts for them, and two heavy bolts I've got left over will be for the backs. There, that's my calculation. Put them to a pot later. Don't know. Okay, the next part now would be to lift it up and turn it over. Obviously just lifting up the very front and letting it flip itself over. Two man job, you'll not do that on your own, I'm pretty sure of that. But before I get to that, I'm just going to have a look at the wiring, because everything's very easy to see here. I'm just going to get it turned over, I'm going to be rolling around on my belly doing it. So I'm just going to have a look at possibly running the two sides up to the front first, then flip it over. Maybe not, we'll have a look. Okay, when putting the wiring loom in, separate the front lead, the one that goes to the plug. There's two plugs there, just disconnect them. You're working down this side, which will be the side that your socket is on the vehicle. That's the easiest, it keeps the hook short. Now then, starting at the back with the small plug, now what you've got is that's going to go to the front light over there. These are going to go to the plug there. These are going to stay at the back. But in order to get it through the little grommet, you need to start at the back here and feed it through the first grommet. And go down that way, up and out that way. So, let's feed all this through there first. So we've got these two plugs in. Now, I've tried this in about 7 different fashions so far. It's become quite annoying until eventually I've come to the solution. That's where I'm going to stop. Right, now I can feed that in. Now I'm not getting it down and up in one swoop, so what I'll do is I'll go down and right out the other end and then use the wire to bring it back in, the threading iron, to bring it back in that last bit. So, down here. Okay, that's in the front now, so next one does the grommet for the front end. I take the front grommet and get that over the cables and into the hole. Okay, so that's safe, that can now go over there. This one, run it back in there. And that can go over to that side. Now there's just grippers on the back of the underside here that will hold these cables in place. You don't need to bother trying to hide it all. This one as well. Okay, so the last part of the wiring now then is to get the socket cable or the plug cable from that point to that. And that's all. Just send that through. And there's the plug set. I thought this would actually have done the same thing. I'll plug them together and see if I can actually get them to go inside that body section.
Get on there like that and you're going to move me. There we go. Yes, yes, it's possible. Yeah, it's gone, it's gone, it's gone. Good. That's what we're going to do here. Okay. This one wants to go up over there.
I'm not flipping them tight, just closing them so it's actually tight. I don't want it banging on it. That's all. Later, once I've got all the plugs in, I'll then determine how close I can have it there. And if I want to tighten it up. This out of here. Really close. That I can do with later on, probably some tape around it, because it's going to be doing a lot of shaking on that. And there's no grommet in that. That's for the side like there. That's for the side like there. Then I'll squash it over again. Okay, that is the wiring room done as much as I need to do for now. What I need to do next is get some help and turn the whole thing. Forward, because there's nothing technical that I've done that needs deep explanations. I got it turned over with the help of the vent. Now I've just assembled the basic sides, which really is just 8 bolts. You stand the side pieces on, put the bolts in. I put the chock wheel on at the front, which again, 2 bolts where it needs to be. If you've got steadies, corner steadies, then put them on as well at this point. It's good because it means you can jump in and walk around the trailer. It's good and stable, and lock it all up. Now, on the tailgates, they are just, let me explain and show you. Just a bar push through with a split pin. Simple as that, nothing technical. When you put it on, if these are not sitting in, it's because this is not square. Slacken that bolt, push it in, and then tighten it back up again. These are adjustable tensioners. That's how you want it. So it's got a reasonable, it's not going to jump up in, with vibrations going down the road. If it's not strong enough, wind it in. If it's too strong, wind it out until it's just right. You've also got a point there where you can put a padlock in or a securing clamp or something in there just to stop it coming off and stop it coming opening again with vibration if you want. You have that at the front as well, because this has got front and back gates that can open for using extra length loads. And that's it, basic sides are on. What we still have to do is mud guards at this point to go onto the body here. There is three locating points there and three holes in the body. Put them on, easy to tell which is front and back. They've got holes for the mud. That's the back, so that's going there. Same with that side. The light cluster comes in a nice steel box. For protection, of course, with a nice rubber trims on it to save cutting your fingers on the steel. Just two bolts in the back there, and you've got space for the plug to be located. That, you can see from the bolt points there, fits onto the side. Two holes in the body, screw them on. Simple as that. And then the wire comes up from underneath, up behind there, and plugs in. Couldn't be simpler. Do the same on the other side. We'll get that done. When that's done, then we can start on putting the cage on the top. Okay, and do that again at the other side. Okay, next we're putting the cage on around the top. First thing to note is that the mesh on the cage walls must be on the inside. I already made the mistake of putting it on the outside and had to undo the whole lot again. So put the mesh on the inside. The tailgate, or the door at the back, actually shows you that it should be on the inside, but it's the last bit you do. And there is no instructions. So let me tell you. Put the mesh on the inside. The bolts to hold it on go through the top, from the top down into a cavity that you can't really get to, so you can't get to the nut to tighten it. So they've given you these box washers, which not only act as washers, they hold the nut solid for you, so you can tighten it from the top. Right, let's get on and get it in. What I'll do is the two sides, put the back on, put the front panel on, then I'll put the gate bit on. Right, sir. Okay, so nearing the finish now. What we've got left to do is things like the mud flap, which goes on there. Self-explanatory, don't need to teach you that. Three small nuts and bolts come with it. Pretty heavy duty for a mud flap. Generally, I'm finding that with the whole trailer. Everything's done very heavily duty. The front side light. on a nice flexi bracket because I know it's going to get hit. Yeah, been thought of. There's two long screws that we get for that. Which are these? With washers and nuts. Put the washer on the rubber end because I think it's going to pop through there easily if it gets smacked too much. If necessary, go get another washer as well. I don't think you'll need it. Right, so that then goes in this end here. In them two holes there. Get it partly through. And it gets connected on the top. That's it. We've got the number plate light. The number plate light goes on this tailboard, which still needs hot moving into place. It's simple. Shove the wire through the hole. Two bolts, bolt on there. And that's it. Your number plate goes on there. That can't be simpler. Holes are already drilled in it. Holes are already drilled in here. Pot rivets, you're given. Even given a pot rivet gun. Again, can't be simpler. Okay, two reflectors for each side. Sticky back, your lid off, put it on the floor. One there. And on top of that bolt there. That's it, that's good enough. Okay. Light, mud flap, reflectors, then we've got the tie down button. They give you a whole job lot of these. They come with screws and nuts. And all the way along the side of the body, there's holes been drilled. And you put one there, put a nut on the other side and tighten it up. Pretty simple. One, two, three, four, five. Each side. And I think some at the back. Yeah, some at the back. Some at there. Word of advice here. Do them before you put this cage on. I'm going to now have to get out somebody to go inside and hold the spanner on there so I can get over to it. The ends, I can do. The sides, I can't. So, right, that's what's left to be done. Okay, I'll carry on doing them later. What's next to do now, as we said earlier, is getting the electrics connected up fully, which means getting this plug onto the end of the trailer wiring, and then plugged into the van and test it to see if it's working. All we've got left to do, as I said again earlier, was these. Tie back buttons. Still have these two bolts left over. Still don't know what they're for. There you go. Nothing falling off. Nothing looks loose. So I guess there wasn't a leak pack, I hope. Okay, putting the plug on. I went on their website. That's Paxton Trailers. And printed off this. I'll leave a copy at the bottom of the video in the comment section. Just basically showing you where to put the wires. We'll use this as a connection to start with and then check and see if it matches what we've got on the vehicle. If not, we can adjust it. Okay, let's get on. Okay, just watching as we go through it. You want about 100mm cut back on the trailer wire, revealing the seven cores. Now for it to go into these connectors and be a decent strength, you want to be folding this cable. Make sure it's long enough. Right, open the plug. I believe you can do that. That'll want to go on the wire to start with. Open up this. Locating lug there, locating lug there. so we know that's correct. Right, now we've got to get this rubber in there, it looks quite tight. Which is good, because it means it's going to be watertight. Right now, solid on that, we don't need it right over, it's just got to sit in there like that and be tight in there. And that's all. No wire showing there. Okay, so let's lengthen the bench first a little bit. Twist them around, hold them on. Okay, numbers are on there. Well, the numbers are on there, but they're so faint. I printed out a picture also that's on the website. You just continue on with that one. A blown up view, which is which. Okay, right, crack on, slacken up all of them first. Make that simple. Start with a simple one, seven, then white, okay, grey or brown. Yeah, we've got grey. Obviously some colour coding groups are different depending on where you get the wire from. There's number six. Also, with it being fine strands, there's none of these strands just wandering around loose, because it can again short out to another one and you will spend a long time trying to work out what the problem is. Well, that goes on the outside, it would seem. This cabling point here. So I want to push a bit more inside. So, and that's it on the outside. Look at your jobs. That will sit inside there and pull them two tight together. And it's gripping so tight onto this insulation. Okay, there we have it. Now we'll get tested. the test there was successful enough, it just indicated the indicator wires just weren't swapping over. They're simple enough, I can do them in the plug. And that's it, done, finished, trailer. So there we have it, one trailer completed. Nothing else left to do, just apart from the little bits that I mentioned. I need to tidy up the wires at the bottom, change the indicator lights over. I'm also going to make a canvas cover. I'll just get some tarpaulin and some rings and cut it and make it fit as it would. It'll be as good as a factory one. You can buy them for 95 quid, but unfortunately, my opinion is that it's easier to do it the way I want to do it. And that's all there is to do. So there you have, one trailer. Now, if you need to assemble one, there it is. Simple. Got any questions about it? Just let us know. Message at the bottom, I'll reply to you. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.